Welcome back to Tamaano Perspective. I have with me Mr. Jun Lozada. Good evening, Jun.
Evening,
and Joey DeVenesha, the original whistleblowers.
Good evening. Good evening.
It's good to see both of you, and thank you for taking the time to join us. I think we should really remind the public about the events surrounding the NBN-ZTE, let's call it a scandal, all right? Mm-hmm. Especially with the filing of these cases against Gloria Arroyo, Leandro Mendoza, and others. I'm going to ask you first, Joey. You know, your father was removed from the speakership. Mm-hmm. Your family was persecuted. Now that these cases are filed against GMA, do you feel somehow vindicated by all of this?
Yeah, I believe so. I mean, I made that expose in 2007.
Yes.
And it was most difficult thing I had to do in my life. It cost my father's job as well. But I feel vindicated, and I believe I've earned the respect of the Filipino people. And the charges now, I mean, the Senate investigation has resulted in something more concrete, which is now in the Sandigan Bayan, which is supposed to be where it is. And I hope that the ombudsman and prosecutors make sure that the evidence they have is strong, and I am willing to testify there to be able to see that to fruition. And I'm glad Mike Arroyo is part of that, GMA, Mendoza, and Abalos, because those are the four people who are really the heads of all the anomalies in the Arroyo administration. But we really have to watch over and try to make this as transparent as possible to ensure that there is a fair result of this trial.
You said that you're willing to testify, Joey. Mm-hmm. Does this mean that you will wait for the court to issue a subpoena, or are you in fact working with the prosecutors now, giving them evidence to prepare for this case?
Well, the evidence is basically what I stated in the Senate, and
okay.
I testified in the Fourth Division last year.
Yes.
Against Chairman Abalos.
Yes.
With the same justices. So this is not the first time I'm going to do this. So normally they would subpoena me, and we would probably go through more of the facts that include GMA now and the First Gentleman and Leandro Mendoza. So I'm not really preparing much for it. But it's been a while.
Okay.
So basically, I'm just trying to remember the timelines and the important events that I had made public in 2007 and also in 2008.
Okay. How about you, Jun? They essentially took away 4 or 5 years of your life, because mm-hmm. I did visit you once or twice in the Sal Green Hills.
Yeah,
you were essentially a prisoner in
yes.
in a very nice place, though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel vindicated as well?
I really do not see this as my own vindication, but
okay.
I'd like to see this more bringing the faith of the people back, like that there's still justice in this land.
Okay.
Okay. I'd like to see those who are done really, really this wrong things to the people to be made to account for their sins. So I'd like this to be the baby steps toward, again, regaining the faith of the people, that faith in goodness, faith in truthfulness, that crime has to pay.
Did you actually think, like, during those 4 or 5 years, that this day would come, that actually charges would be filed against GMA and her family?
Yes, I did. Because during those times, I had like offers to move abroad,
okay.
both from good sources and bad sources.
So, can we ask who these bad sources were?
I think the guys were like afraid of our testimony. No? So, and yeah, I think what kept me going, even in those lonely days, lonely months, lonely years,
okay.
to hold on, is that hope that someday things will be done right.
Are you going to testify?
Yes, I will.
Are you working with the prosecution? Or
we've been working with the prosecution, even for the Abalos and Neri case.
Yes.
As Joey has said, we had testified before the Sandigan. We know the drill already.
Okay.
And then the nice thing about just being truthful, telling the truth, is you really don't have to prepare much. You just
it's
have
easy.
To tell the truth. Yeah,
that's
you
right.
don't have
that's right.
to remember the lies. You don't have to remember the what cover up, what alibi you used here. Just say it as it is.
But doesn't your family tell you, June, something like, you've already spent so much time prosecuting this, Like, aren't you being pressured by your family to just, you know, forget about this, just move on?
Okay. Contrary to that, my wife and the kids tell me, like, let's finish this fight.
Okay.
To the end. Even when it was yet so difficult, or when it was still very difficult. And
because it was especially difficult on your kids, if I recall.
And I was fortunate that, unknown to me, my wife would always explain to the kids what was going on. Even when I was sent to jail, she has to explain why I have to go to jail. And the children would, together with my wife, I said, how about let's finish this?
All right.
Meaning whatever we have started, we have sacrificed for, let's finish this. Let's see this through its rightful conclusion.
Okay, how about you, Joey? Is there any latest information on these two ZTE officials? And I think we got the name of one of them wrong.
Yeah, the Vice President of International is Yu Yong.
Yeah, any news on them?
Well, just the news reports that they may testify or willing to testify, but you know, that's kind of maybe a bit difficult because them being from another foreign land, just to bring them here, and it would bring some embarrassment to the Chinese government. Corruption is in China. I mean, they will put you to death if you wouldn't be involved in something like this. So I don't know what will happen if they can, but I hope that the testimonies of all the witnesses, including June and I and their Dante Madriaga, and even the witnesses that may come out from the other side.
All right.
Leo San Miguel, Ruben Reyes, unfortunately, Chief Inspector De La Torre has already passed away.
Okay.
But, you know, there are some people that may come up and know, you know, advances that were made in this transaction.
Okay.
And when I was in Shenzhen with Chairman Abalos and Fan Yang, who was the account officer, was saying, what about the advances that we have made to you, Mr. Chairman? What about those? Because Chairman Abalos was already asking for this money to be given to the first gentleman, to be given to the president, to be given to the political party.
Did you testify on that? Because let's make it very clear. I think this part of the story, it's not yet that clear with the public. That in fact, money had already changed hands.
Yes.
How much money was this? When did this happen? And to whom did it go to?
Well, the monies that were changed hands, based the numbers, is $42 million.
Is that pesos or dollars?
Dollars. $42 million, as stated by Dante Madriaga in the Senate testimony.
Okay.
Dante Madriaga was working with the other side, with Leo San Miguel.
And who gave this?
And this was given by ZTE
to
Chairman Abalos. And supposedly is given to First Gentleman Mike Arroyo for the campaign, and I don't know what was left.
This was for the 2007 campaign?
To the 2007 elections. And if you remember, Mike Arroyo got sick, and he was in the ICU. And the ZTE officials were saying, we're not going to advance any more money unless Mike Arroyo shows up here or your president. So the President Arroyo had to fly from the ICU at St. Luke's
to
China.
Yes.
At 2 a.m. in the morning to witness a signing between Leandro Mendoza, Republic of the Philippines, and ZTE officials to sign this $329 million contract, which is really just worth $132 million.
Yes.
And was witnessed by our president.
Isn't this somehow connected to the, or this should be connected to the electoral sabotage case? Because if the funding that they were getting was for the elections to pay off people, I would just like to know, is this going to be part of the electoral sabotage case? Or?
Well, I don't want to prejudice the case, but if you connect the dots, the dots are there to be able to see the money flow. So it will be dependent on the lawyers and Senator Pimentel on how they will present, and Senator and Mr. De Lima on how they're going to present that
but
case.
But you can actually connect these two cases.
Yes, definitely.
At least that's the thread that I'm seeing here.
Definitely.
June, I have to ask you, let's put some scope into all of this. How much money were you offered?
We were like a jukebox then. No?
Okay. So why a jukebox?
Because it started off with a few hundred million.
Okay.
And then as the crisis would deepen, and some will say, another emissary would come and say, this is on top of what they're giving you, so here's another 150.
So how much all in all were you offered? And why were they offering you that money?
Before that, first is to keep myself quiet.
Okay.
And after, we have already...
Quiet because you knew about this transaction.
Yeah, and then that we can really point out to meaning to the perpetrators.
Okay. Mm.
And after the Senate investigation that we have already appeared, okay. We're being paid off to retract.
Okay.
To take back our statement and to point to some opposition personalities as the one who were orchestrating this.
Are you at liberty to say who these people were who were offering you this money?
No, I cannot.
At this time, point in time, you cannot?
Yeah.
Okay.
But, looking back, it's a few hundred million pesos because we don't want to say the full amount because and then the burden will be upon us. They can just easily deny it.
And how about you, Joey? How much were you offered to essentially back off from this transaction?
Well, to back off, it was $10 million. Okay. That was the offer made by Chairman Abalos to me in 2006.
Okay, I have to grapple with you with that. Both of you, I got to grapple with
you with
that because most people would find it hard to believe that you're going to turn down $10 million and 700 million pesos. I'll start with you, Joey. What made you decide to turn it down?
Well, firstly, I don't think most people would have that opinion. I think most people would say, I mean, I wasn't born that way, number one. I don't accept bribes.
Okay.
I am not corrupt. And I knew that this money was being offered to me so that they could to be able to do this transaction, which was worth a lot more.
Yes.
In fact, the tongpats, as June calls it, is $200 million.
Okay.
So $10 million is nothing. But even if it was one peso or $1 million, I will not accept it because that was a bribe and that's against my values. And I was not raised by my
father. Your dad that way.
But by that way.
Okay.
Yes.
How about you, June? What was your what was the reason or the basis for your turning it down?
First, because of the price.
Okay.
That they're asking for that money. The price is you have to go and tell a lie.
Okay.
A brazen lie to the entire nation, no? So I've been telling them that I will not lie for them.
Okay. Any final message, Joey, or a final word from you?
Well, firstly, I wanted to thank our viewers and the Filipino people for supporting me in those very tough times.
Okay.
Especially during the time when she was still in power.
Yes.
My life was death threats. I had to postpone my wedding for a few years. I had to secure my son, and you know it was very tough. And I really felt down. But you know, whenever I meet people, they would tell me, Joey, we're supportive of you. So I want to thank those people. And also, it's nice to see when I bump into people now. They say, Joey, buti na lang nakulong na sila. You know, before is ano bang nangyari? Meron bang mangyayari? Ngayon meron nang
at least now
may there's a
at least now there's a reckoning.
Yeah.
Final word, June.
For me, similar to Joey, we'd like to thank and also tell the people that they should not be tired of this.
Okay.
Because our justice system has been known not to be not for its expediency or for this, but it is going to take a drag a long time, and I hope it doesn't follow the martial law cases that until now. But final word maybe is that hopefully this would again, as I said, bring back our faith, what is right and what is good.
Mm-hmm. Okay. On that note, thank you, June. Thank you, Joey. And stay tuned for more Tamano Perspective.